In this video, I'm going to show you how to use VLOOKUP with multiple criteria so you can zero in on the exact numbers you need, even when your dataset has more than one column you have to match. Imagine you manage nationwide gadget sales, and you need to know exactly how many iPhones sold in New York last quarter. One column lists cities, another lists products, a third holds the sales figures. And you're thinking, a regular VLOOKUP can only check one column. Now what? Don't worry, by the end of this tutorial, you'll have two rock-solid solutions, plus a downloadable practice file so you can follow along at your own pace. The link is waiting for you in the comments section. Let's dive right into the first method, adding a helper column. Open your spreadsheet, add a blank column just to the right of your existing data, and type a heading such as key. Now we're going to create a unique identifier for every row by stitching together the city and product names. Start by typing an equals sign. Next, click the first city cell in your row, then type an ampersand. After the ampersand, type a dash enclosed in quotation marks so the result reads more clearly. Then type another ampersand. Finally, click the product cell in the same row. Press enter, and you'll see a combined value like New York iPhone. Now double-click the small square at the bottom right of the cell to copy the formula through the entire column. With every row now holding its own unique key, it's time to build the two criteria lookup. Click where you'd like the result to appear, usually in a summary table off to the side. Begin by typing an equal sign and then the word VLOOKUP in capital letters followed by an open parenthesis. For the lookup value, recreate the same key you just built. Click the cell that will hold your city input, type an ampersand. Enter the dash in quotes. Add another ampersand, and then click the cell that will hold your product input. Put in a comma. For the range, highlight the entire helper column you created, plus the sales column immediately next to it. This keeps things lean and fast. Add another comma. The next piece Excel wants is the column number inside that range that contains the answer. Because sales is the second column of our highlighted block, type the number 2. Add another comma. Finally, tell Excel you want an exact match by typing the word false. Close the parenthesis and press enter. If everything lines up, the iPhone sales for New York should appear instantly. Anytime you change either the city or the product in your input cells, the result updates automatically, giving you a slick dashboard-like experience. That helper column trick works great, but it still feels a little clunky. An extra column, hard-coded numbers, and the age-old limitation that VLOOKUP can only look to the right. Excel now offers a more streamlined answer, XLOOKUP. Think of it as the modern upgrade that simplifies multiple criteria searches without additional columns. To set it up, click a fresh result cell and type an equals sign followed by XLOOKUP in caps and an open parenthesis. The first thing XLOOKUP requests is the lookup value. So once again, we'll concatenate our city and product inputs. Click your city cell, type an ampersand, and then click your product cell. No dash or other punctuation is required this time because we simply need a combined string that is unique. Type a comma. Next, XLOOKUP asks for the lookup array, which is where it should search. Instead of a single helper column, we'll build the search array on the fly. Highlight the entire city column in your data. Type an ampersand, and then highlight the entire product column. This live concatenation tells Excel to check both criteria in tandem, row by row. Type another comma. Now Excel wants the return array, the column holding the value we care about, so highlight the sales column. You can ignore the optional arguments that follow for now. Close the parenthesis and hit enter. Instantly, you get the same answer you saw earlier, but without adding a helper column or counting column numbers. Plus, the formula is flexible. Your data can grow in any direction and XLOOKUP won't break. Quick side note, If you copy this XLOOKUP down or across, remember to lock the data ranges. Inside the formula bar, place your cursor on each range reference. In our case, the city column, product column, and sales column. Then press F4 so dollar signs appear. That way, when you drag the formula, your ranges remain anchored and your results stay correct. Before we wrap up, I want to show you how fast this works in practice. Change the product input from iPhone to Galaxy or switch the city to Chicago and watch how instant the result is. Pretty slick, right? Now, if you're ready to level up fast, hit the video on screen right now. It's my free, no-fluff Excel crash course that takes you from the absolute basics to the advanced moves you'll actually use on the job. Give it a click, start shining at work today, and when you finish, you'll be eligible for an official Excel Basics certification you can drop straight onto your LinkedIn. See you in class!